Now let's make sure that this program has all the properties we want, namely concurrency, absence of deadlock, and mutual exclusion of the important shared memory. Does it have concurrency? For this, we just need to convince ourselves that the critical sections of the code are short. This critical section here is just decrementing a variable and sending a signal. Not much work to be done there. And the tracker does the analogous thing. So we're okay on that front. The top two blocks, just this one and this one, these just check the condition and then call the wait procedure. And then they immediately unlock afterwards. So this also is short. Okay, so let's check off concurrency. For the absence of deadlock, we can convince ourselves that both threads are never blocked. We can see that the mutex lock can't be responsible for a deadlock because both the producer and the consumer give up the lock writing after acquiring it, just as we argued about concurrency. There isn't much work to be done here, nor is there much going on up here. It's just a matter of checking the value of the buff avail variable. That leaves the possibility that we get blocked on one of these conwait calls. Let's suppose that our digitizer is blocked on this line because he's waiting for buff avail to be greater than zero. Let's suppose that the digitizer is blocked because he's waiting for a signal saying that buff avail is greater than zero. We know that right after conwait was called, buff avail was zero. Remember, we had the lock at the time. This means that the tracker can't possibly be blocked on its wait because that would imply that buff avail were equal to max. We also know that our digitizer unlocked the mutex variable. Again, that's part of the conwait call. Hence, our tracker can't be blocked on this while he tries to acquire the lock either. Eventually, the tracker will get around to incrementing buff avail and then sending the signal back to the digitizer thread. And so we can be confident that eventually this signal will arrive and we'll exit this procedure. The argument is analogous if we suppose that the tracker is waiting on conwait. That means that digitizer will be able to make progress and eventually decrement buff avail and send the signal. All right, so hopefully we've convinced ourselves that there's no deadlock. Lastly, we want to convince ourselves that we have achieved mutual exclusion of the necessary shared memory. Well, the use of these mutex locks around all the accesses and writes to buff avail should convince ourselves that we don't have erase there. That leaves the frame buff variable. But the logic of the program, that is the logic of the ring buffer that we talked about earlier, prevents the head from ever catching up with the tail or vice versa as they chase each other around the ring buffer. In fact, that's the whole point of the buff avail variable. So mutual exclusion is achieved, and our program has all three properties that we desired.